Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about panels in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, people, let's discuss JPanels. It's a GUI component that functions as a container to hold other components, and you can add a JPanel to a frame, and it will sort of section off areas of your frame. So let's create a frame. So I'm just going to paste this just to save a little bit of time. So JFrame frame equals new frame. Be sure to include any necessary imports. Frame.set default close operation, JFrame exit on close. We're going to be using no layout manager, at least until we get to the video discussing layout managers. So frame.set layout null, because we're manually going to place all of the components that we have. Frame.setSize 750 by 750 and frame.setVisible true. Now, to create a JPanel, it's very similar to creating a JFrame. So we say JPanel, let's call this panel equals new JPanel. And let's change the background color and be sure to include any necessary imports. So we'll say panel.setBackground. And let's pass in a color. So color, let's make this red. Actually, since we're going to be creating a few different panels, let's instead call this maybe red panel. Then we'll have a maybe blue panel and a green panel. So be sure to change that here as well. Then we're going to set the bounds since we're using no layout manager. We have to manually place the coordinates and the width and the height of this panel. So red panel dot set bounds. So we need X and Y for where this panel is going to be placed, as well as the width and the height. So for the X position, let's put this where X is 0, where Y is 0. So this is going to be in the top left corner of the frame. And for the width, let's make this 250 by 250. So it's a square. And then lastly, this is very easy to forget about. We need to add this panel to the frame. So let's do that at the end. Frame.add, what are we adding? We're adding a component. Our JPanel is a component. Let's add that. Red panel. And let's run this. So this is our frame and this is our panel. We can add components to the panel just like what we can do with our frame. So let's create a few other panels to create different sections for this frame. Like this is one section, we can create a different section to hold other components. And then we can add components, kind of like what we did with our frame. So let's create maybe a blue panel this time. So I'm going to copy this, change red to blue, and make sure to change it here as well. So blue panel and blue panel. And we'll change the color to blue. And let's place this where X is 250, Y is 0, and we'll keep the dimensions the same. And we need to add this panel to the frame. So frame.add blue panel. So now we should have a blue panel next to our red panel, which we do. And let's create one more panel, maybe a larger one that's green that will take up this section of our frame. So let's call this green panel. So let's change blue to green. So green, 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 and here as well. So we'll place this where X is 0, Y is 250, and let's make this 500 by 250. And then we need to add this to the frame. So frame.add green panel. And then this should give us a nice square that's made up of separate JPanels. Cool. Yeah, so those are JPanels. Let's add a component. So let's make a label. So let's do this at the top. JLabel label equals new JLabel. And I'll set some text as well. So label.set text Hi. And you can add an icon too if you want. I'll do that just for this demonstration. We'll need to create an image icon. So image icon icon equals new image icon. And this file that I have is thumbsup.png, and it looks like this. So this is thumbsup.png. And include this import. But I misspelled image. Alright, then label.setIcon. Alright, now with this label, we can add this to either the frame, or we can add this to a panel. So let's add this to one of the panels. Let's say the red panel. So let's add that here. So instead of saying frame.addLabel, we're going to say the panel that we want to add this to, because these panels function like containers. So let's add this to the red panel. So red panel.addLabel. And this should appear in our red panel, which it does. Let's instead add this to a different panel, like the blue panel. And now this label is contained within the blue panel. And let's try it for the green panel. And now this label appears in the green panel. And you can also move this label around within the container too. However, these panels, they use something called a flow layout manager. And in the last video on labels, the frames that we use have a border layout. All you really need to know about flow layouts right now is that with components that you add to a container that's using a flow layout manager, it will take all these components, stick them to the top, and center them, and it will add components until this first row is filled. Once that row is filled, it's going to add components to the second row. But for now, we don't really know how that works. That's a video for a different day. Let's just set the layout for our panel to a border layout just because we're comfortable with that. And then later I'll demonstrate using no layout manager and how we can place this label. So let's set the layout for our green panel, and we're kind of comfortable with border layouts now and moving labels within a frame that's using a border layout. So green panel dot set layout, and then we can pass in a new border layout. So this is the same layout that our JFrame uses, and if we're using the border layout, it's going to place any components to the center vertically and to the left horizontally. And then we can use set vertical and set horizontal alignment for this label to move this label around within the container. And then later we'll set no layout manager so we can place coordinates if you prefer to do it that way. So let's set the vertical and horizontal alignment for this label. So we'll do that at the top. Label.set vertical alignment, and this takes a constant, J label, and let's move this to the top. So then our label will move as far as it can to the top vertically, and it gets stuck at the top of this container because, well, it's a container. It doesn't like to allow components outside of the container. And if we were to set this to bottom, take a wild guess, it's going to move to the bottom of the container. And then let's also set the horizontal alignment because we can. So label.set horizontal alignment, and we can pick left, center, or right. Let's pick the right this time, so J label dot right. And our label will stick to the bottom and to the right of the container that it's in. Now, what if we switch this label to a different panel, like the red panel? First, we'll just want to change the layout that we're using, so let's change the red panel layout to a new border layout, and then we're going to add our label to the red panel this time. So let's take a guess as to where this label is going to move to. It's going to move to the bottom right corner of the red panel, and if we switch this to blue, And I'm just going to copy this because we'll want to set this to a border layout. So blue panel and blue panel dot add label. Now this is within the bottom right of the blue panel. So what if you don't want to use a layout manager? Well, this is what we can do. We're going to set null for the layout for each of these panels. So let's change this to null for all three panels. And let's take a look to see what changes were made. All right, so we need to set the bounds for this label now. So let's do that here. Label.setBounds. We're going to place X coordinate, a Y coordinate, a width and a height. So let's say we want this in the top left corner, that is where X is 0 and Y is 0. Let's say for the width, this will be 75, and for the height, 75 as well. Now, we added our label to the blue panel, so it's going to be in the top left corner of the blue panel, and not necessarily the top left corner of our frame, because with set bounds, it's going to place your component at these coordinates relative to the container that it's in. Since this label is within the blue panel, the blue panel is acting as the container and not necessarily the frame. So if we were to move this label to a different panel, it's going to be within a new container. So let's say we want to add this label to the green panel. So now this label is going to be in the top left of our green panel, and you can do the same thing with red too. And then if we were to move the X position and Y position of this label, let's say 100 and 100. And now this label is moved down on the Y axis by 100 pixels and on the X axis to the right by 100 pixels relative to the corner of the container that it's within this green panel and not necessarily the frame itself. So we don't really need this set vertical alignment and set horizontal alignment if you're using no layout manager. This is something you'll want to use if you're using a border layout. All right, everybody, so that's the basics of panels. It's basically a GUI component that functions as a container to hold other components. So you can add components to a panel, and then you can add the panel to a frame. So that's the basics of panels. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of panels in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.